Hello students, welcome to third lecture of work and energy. Students, in previous lecture we saw units of work, relationship between joule and erg, definitions of positive work, negative work and zero work, as well as we saw examples of work also. In this lecture, starting with energy, why does it happen? First, if a pot having a plant is kept in the dark, the plant languishes. Here, you can see the difference between the plant grown in light and the one plant which grown in darkness. Second one, on increasing the volume of a music system or TV beyond a limit, the vessels in the house start vibrating. Here, in this picture, due to loud sound, the glass got shattered, that is broken into pieces. Third one, collecting sunlight on a paper with the help of a convex lens burns the paper. See students, in this picture, this paper burned due to solar energy, that is sun's heat. Now, let's see the definition of energy. The capacity of a body to perform work is called its energy. I repeat, the capacity of a body to perform work is called its energy. That is, every body or object has a different capacity to do work and hence have different energies. The units of work and energy are the same. Hence, the unit of energy in SI system is joule, while that in CGS system is erg. Remember students, unit of energy in SI system is joule and in CGS system is erg. You have learned that energy exists in various forms like mechanical energy, heat energy, light energy, sound energy, electromagnetic energy, chemical energy, nuclear energy and solar energy. In this chapter, we are going to study two forms of mechanical energy, namely potential energy and kinetic energy. Now let's see first kinetic energy. What will happen in the following cases? First case, a fast cricket ball strikes the stumps. So see in this picture, because of moving ball, bells and stumps come in motion. Second case, the striker hits a coin on the carom board. In this case, because of striker, this coin comes in motion. Third, one marble strikes another in a game of marbles. See in the picture, because of moving marble, other stationary marbles comes in motion. From the above examples, we understand that when a moving object strikes a stationary object, the stationary object moves. Thus, the moving object has same energy, part or all of which it shares with the stationary object, thereby setting it in motion. So definition, the energy which an object has because of its motion is called its kinetic energy. I repeat, the energy which an object has because of its motion is called its kinetic energy. So students, object in motion always has kinetic energy. The work done by a force to displace a stationary object through a distance s is the kinetic energy gained by the object. Thus, kinetic energy is equal to work done on the object. Therefore, kinetic energy is equal to force into displacement. Now, let's say expression for kinetic energy. Suppose a stationary object of mass m moves because of an applied force. Let u be its initial velocity, here u is equal to 0. Here it is given that object is stationary, That is why initial velocity u is equal to 0. Let the applied force be F. This force generates an acceleration A in the object. And after time t, due to acceleration, the velocity of object becomes v. The displacement during this time is s. So, in short, let m is equal to mass of object, u is equal to initial velocity of an object, here initial velocity u is equal to 0, f is applied force, a is acceleration, t is time, v is final velocity of an object, and s is displacement of the object. Good. Now, work done on the object is, work is equal to force into displacement, that is W is equal to F into S. This is our equation number 1. According to Newton's second law of motion, force is equal to mass into acceleration. Therefore, F is equal to M into A, equation 2. Similarly, using Newton's second equation of motion, S is equal to ut plus half at square. But initial velocity is 0, that is u is equal to 0. Put this u is equal to 0 in above equation, we get S is equal to 0 plus half at square. Therefore, S is equal to half at square, equation 3. Now, using equations 2 and 3 in equation 1, we get W is equal to MA into 1 upon 2 at square. Hence, W is equal to half MA square T square. Therefore, W is equal to 1 upon 2 M into bracket at square, equation number 4. Now, using Newton's first equation of motion, which is V is equal to U plus AT. But here, initial velocity u is equal to 0. So, using u is equal to 0 in above equation, we get v is equal to 0 plus at. Therefore, v is equal to a into t. Squaring on both sides, we get v square is equal to at bracket square, equation number 5. Now, using equation 5 in equation 4, we get w is equal to 1 upon 2 mv square. We know that the kinetic energy gained by an object is the amount of work done on the object. Hence, kinetic energy is equal to W work done. Therefore, kinetic energy is equal to 1 upon 2 mv square. Very important formula. Remember this formula. Kinetic energy is equal to 1 upon 2 mv square. Now, let's see one example based on kinetic energy. A stone having a mass of 250 grams is falling from a height. How much kinetic energy does it have at the moment when its velocity is 2 meters per second? Now, let's see given first. A stone having a mass of 250 grams. So, mass of 250 grams, that means m is equal to 250 grams. And velocity is given as 2 meter per second. Hence, v is equal to 2 meter per second. Students, here velocity is in SI system, whereas mass is given in CJ system. But units must be in the same system. So, mass, which is given here in gram in CJ system, must be converted into kg, that is in SI system. Therefore, to convert mass into kg, we divide mass by 1000. Therefore, m is equal to 0.25 kg. Here, we have to find out kinetic energy. Hence, formula for kinetic energy is, kinetic energy is equal to 1 upon 2 mv square. Now, substituting the given values, we get 1 upon 2 into 0.25 value of mass into 2 square value of V, which is equal to 1 upon 2 into 0.25 into 4. And after calculation, we get the value of kinetic energy as 0.5 joule. Now, next form of mechanical energy is potential energy. Let's see some examples of potential energy in our day-to-day life. First, an arrow is released from a stretched bow. Second, water kept at a height flows through a pipe into the tank below. Third, a compressed spring is released. So, which words describe the state of object in the above examples? And the answer is the words stretched, kept at a height, and compressed describe the state of the object. Next question. Where did the energy required to cause the motion of the objects come from? And the answer of this question is the energy required to cause the motion came from the energy stored in the system, that is potential energy of the system. If the object were not brought in those states, would they have moved? No. Therefore, students, definition of potential energy is the energy stored in an object because of its specific state or position is called its potential energy. I repeat, the energy stored in an object because of its specific state or position is called its potential energy. Now, let's see expression for potential energy. To carry an object of mass m to a height h above the earth's surface, a force F is equal to m into g has to be used against the direction of the gravitational force. Students, here g is acceleration due to gravity. The amount of work done, W, is equal to force into displacement. Therefore, W is equal to F into S. Therefore, W is equal to mg into S from F is equal to m into g. Hence, W is equal to mgh. Therefore, the amount of potential energy stored in the object because of its displacement. Potential energy is equal to mgh as work is equal to potential energy. And m is the mass of the object, g is acceleration due to gravity, and h is the height. Now, let's see example of potential energy. 500 kg water is stored in the overhead tank of a 10 meter high building. Calculate the amount of potential energy stored in the water. Given of the question is 500 kg water. Therefore, write m mass is equal to 500 kg. Height of the building is 10 meter. Hence, h is equal to 10 meter. And take g acceleration due to gravity is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. And this value is fixed and constant. We have to calculate here potential energy. And formula for potential energy is equal to mgh. By substituting the given values in formula, we get potential energy is equal to 10 into 9.8 into 500 equal to 98 into 500. Therefore, potential energy is equal to 49,000 joule. Students, Ajay and Atul have been asked to determine the potential energy of a ball of mass m kept on a table as shown in the figure. What answers will they get? Will they be different? Of course, their answers will be different because height of ball with respect to them are different. What do you conclude from this? Potential energy is relative. As height is increases, potential energy is also increases. As height decreases, potential energy is also decreases. Therefore, we can say that potential energy is relative. The height of the ball with respect to Ajay and Atul are different. So, the potential energy with respect to them will be different. Now, let's see transformation of energy. Which are the different forms of energy? Which type of energy is used in each of the following processes? First, a stretched piece of rubber. Piece of rubber is stretched. So, here potential energy is stored. Second, fast moving car. Here, car is moving. So, here, kinetic energy is there. Third, the whistling of a cooker due to steam. Here, because of steam, cooker is whistling. So, here, pressure is converted into sound. So, this is sound energy's example. Fourth, the crackers exploded in Diwali. So, chemical energy stored in crackers, and when they exploded, it converted into light, heat and sound energy. Fifth, a fan running on electricity. Here, fan is moving. So, type of energy is kinetic energy. Sixth, drawing out pieces of iron from garbage using magnet. Here, magnet is used. So, type of energy is magnetic energy. Seventh, breaking of a glass window pane because of a loud noise. So, type of energy is sound energy. So, from these examples, we come to know that energy can be transformed from one type to another. For example, the exploding firecrackers converts the chemical energy stored in them into light, sound and heat energy. Students, observe the diagram and see how transformation of energy takes place. Now, let us start with conversion of electrical energy into mechanical energy, and its example is engine or fan. And mechanical energy can also be converted into electrical energy with the help of a device called as generator. Electrical energy is converted into light energy, example electric lamp. Light energy is also converted into electrical energy, example solar cell, photoelectric cell. Electrical energy is converted into chemical energy, example secondary cell, battery. Chemical energy is also converted into electrical energy, primary cell, example simple lead cell, which you have already studied in 8th standard. Electrical energy is converted into sound energy, example loudspeaker. Also, sound energy is converted into electrical energy, example microphone. Now, electrical energy is converted into heat energy, example heater. Also, heat energy is converted into electrical energy, example thermocouple. Thermocouple is used to convert heat energy into electrical energy. Students, from this diagram, we come to know that energy can be transformed from one type to another. Let's see law of conservation of energy. The law states that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can be converted from one form into another. Thus, the total amount of energy in the universe is constant. I repeat, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can be converted from one form into another. Thus, the total amount of energy in the universe remains constant. Students, it is very important law. At last, today's homework is, first, derive the expression for kinetic and potential energy. Second, solve the examples based on kinetic energy and potential energy. Third, practice and learn the law of conservation of energy. And fourth one, attempt the try this from textbook page number 25, figure 2.6. Thank you, everyone.